Hey Canucks fans, welcome to Clay's Canucks Commentary for Friday, May the 24th. I'm Clay Emo, I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter, I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club, and this is my Canucks take, all in one take. Today, I want to talk about the NHL draft, the entry draft that's coming up in Vancouver, Rogers Arena, June 21st and June 22nd, so less than a month away. But I'm not going to talk about who the Canucks should pick at number 10, at the 10th overall pick in the first round, or who they should find in the later rounds on Saturday. I want to talk about the tickets. I want to talk about attending the draft. I want to talk about people that are going, people that are thinking of going, people that are buying tickets, selling tickets, because it's caused quite the uproar, quite the furor on social media in the past week. Actually, really since yesterday, because as you may know, season ticket holders were able to buy a select number of tickets as early as last week, Thursday, May the 26th, and then, Thursday, May the 16th. So that was for full season ticket holders. Then half pack and quarter pack were able to buy earlier this week. And then finally, tickets went on sale to the general public yesterday, Thursday, May the 23rd. And by that time, there weren't a lot of seats left. So let's lay out what the situation is, and then let's talk about the situation. So here's the situation. Day one, the tickets were $28, and it was assigned seating. So you have to pick your seats, and there weren't a lot of seats really available, especially in the lower bowl, because as the Vancouver Canucks announced, it's an NHL event. It's not necessarily the Vancouver Canucks. NHL is controlling the ticketing, and a lot of the lower bowl, the majority of the lower bowl, is understandably for players and their families and media and team representatives, sponsors, all that thing. So a lot of the lower bowl was going to be full. So day one, $28. Day two was only $11, and that was assigned seating for the lower bowl, pick your seats, or general seating for the upper bowl. But again, $11 versus $28. Obviously, day two is a little more, a lot slower, not televised, quite boring. You know, if you're not paying, if you don't know a lot of the prospects, so you're basically waiting for your team to pick. And I've been told that people bring books, people just kind of wander around the concourse, and I'm looking forward to that. That's actually my 45th birthday, and as you know, I'm going back to the draft after spending 8 hours at Sean's aftergrad from midnight to 8 a.m. So I might be a bit of a zombie. I might fall asleep in my chair, but I'm also looking forward to, in my seat, but I'm also looking forward to walk around meeting a bunch of Canucks fans and having everyone greet me happy 45th birthday. But I digress. So that's basically the situation. And then for the tickets themselves, there weren't a lot available, especially yesterday when people, the general public, tried to buy them. So what that really created was the secondary market that has already exploded. And I've seen tickets, I looked it up, I've seen tickets on StubHub for as low, like starting at $250 on the low end, US, and I've seen tickets as high as 500 US, a single ticket for the Friday night. So why would you pay 500 US, i.e. what's that, $650 Canadian, where you could have paid 28, or you could be watching for free at home with the comforts of your own cheap food and your own restroom to yourself, and whatever it may be. So, you know, it depends on the experience. And obviously, for some people, they want to go at any cost because, you know, who knows if they'll get a chance to go to another draft in Vancouver. We don't know when it's going to be. This is the third one in the past 3 decades, but who knows when the next one's going to be. So I get it. It's an event, and I'm excited to go, and I'll get to that in a second. But there are others who will watch on TV gladly and in the comforts of their own home and will be happy to make a couple dollars if they're fortunate to sell tickets. So that's really what I get into here, is we know that a lot of people, I just talked about the secondary market as 250 to 500 US for a single ticket on Friday, which is crazy. So my question was simply, do you fault people? Do you blame people? Does it upset you when you see that people are selling their draft tickets for a massive profit? And I put a poll up on Twitter last week, actually, after I got my tickets as a season ticket holder. I'm very lucky. So I got 2 tickets on Friday going with my season ticket partner, Mike. And then I have 4 tickets on Saturday going with my son, Sean. He'll probably be even more tired than I am. And then we're going to go with a couple friends. But regardless, I do have tickets to both days. Feel very blessed. And I didn't once think about selling them because I want to go. I want to share that experience with Mike on Friday. I want to share that experience with Sean on Saturday. And I had no thoughts at all about selling my tickets. Saturday, let's be real, people are talking about selling their Friday tickets. Saturday, you can still buy general public. So we're talking really about Friday, day one, the televised one, the first round. That's the excitement. So I put a poll up on Twitter and said, you know, for those people that are buying, season ticket members that are buying their draft tickets and then reselling them on the secondary market, how does that make you feel? And I gave 3 options. It makes you mad, It's their right to do so, and I'm indifferent. I got 700 votes on that poll, and 48% of those 700 votes, almost 50%, 48% said, that makes me mad. 32% said they can do what they want, it's their right, and 20% said they're indifferent. So that's good. 80% actually gave an opinion, and of those 80%, 48, so whatever, 60% of those 80%, if that makes sense. So 48% overall said that makes them mad, where only 32% said they can do what they want. So let's talk about both arguments. And I come at this admittedly as a season ticket holder for 9 years now, so whether that weighs into any of this at all. There's the argument for those that, that say that it's the season ticket member's right to sell, to do whatever they want. And that's true. Obviously, season ticket members spend a lot of money per season, over many seasons, and it's been very hard to resell, even to give tickets away. Whatever you want to do with those season tickets, if you don't go to all 41 home games during the regular season, it has been hard to make your money back. So some would say that that season ticket members are basically subsidizing the team, or more importantly, a better way of putting it is they need to be subsidized themselves from a standpoint of they're putting in so much money into the team, probably losing money for the past 4 or 5 seasons. So any money that they can get back through a sale of a draft ticket, then good for them, to each his own, and it's their right to do so. And I get that argument. I really, really do. And others would say, well, that the rich get richer, so to speak, or I can't afford to be season ticket members, and these guys they're in that privileged position, and yet they're still trying to make more money. So that I think that's kind of the crux of the argument right there, right? Is do season ticket members have the right to do so? And I would say yes, they do. I wouldn't personally, but they have the right to do what they want. And if someone wants to spend $200, $300, $400, $500, $600 on a ticket, I'm not going to insult that person's intelligence, but maybe they really want to go. But then that season ticket member usually has the right, free market, supply and demand, all those economic arguments, they have the right to do so. So that's kind of the argument of, it's okay if a season ticket member sells their ticket for a big profit, because it's their right to do so. They've earned that right. They got the pre-sale. They got access, exclusive access, to early access to tickets. But they've earned that right by being a season ticket holder, by spending thousands of dollars on the team throughout the years. That's one argument. The other argument, the argument that makes people mad, is they're like, well, I'm not a season ticket member. I can't afford to be. Yet I'm just as big of a fan, maybe even a bigger fan than some of these season ticket members. And yet I'm shut out. There's barely any tickets when I go on a Ticketmaster. So by the time I enter all my info or pick my seats, they're given away to someone else, or someone else beat me to it. So I'm already trying hard, very hard, to get tickets, and I can't. And now I want to go. I'm an honest, hardworking person, and I can't afford $200, $300, $400 a ticket. I just wanted to go for that $28 a ticket. So A, there was limited availability, and B, now I simply can't afford it because I can't find a ticket for that cost. Yet I'm a big fan, and you have season ticket members who are already in the arena upwards of 20, 30, 40 times a season. I'm barely there, and yet I'm getting shut out once again. And I guess that's, if I may, that's the argument for people who think that it's wrong that season ticket members resell their seats. So those are the two arguments, right? I'm mad and it's not fair and I can't get tickets and now it's too expensive for me to get tickets, versus, hey, I'm a season ticket member and it's my right. And I admit, I always joke around as, oh, I'm not here to judge, or I can't judge people's intentions, and I still hold true to that. Every person has a different situation. I'm a season ticket member who will refuse to sell, even though my wife wants me to sell, which is kind of funny, to be honest. But no, I want to go to both days. Whereas I know I have good friends with a lot of season ticket members who bought with the intention of selling one of the 2 days or whatever it may be, and I can't judge them. But what's really interesting is I've flipped back and forth while trying not to judge. I will admit to you guys that when I first saw people selling their tickets for season, for profits, I was upset. I was upset because I actually thought about the people who voted, I'm mad. I thought about those people, the people who can't, and I'm not trying to be a hero or a martyr, but I did think about the people who can't get into the arena, who are big fans, and who are simply being priced out of the market because of the resale market. So that's the first way I was leaning. And if you saw in my tweets from last week, I kind of I didn't go crazy, but I was kind of leaning that way. But then as I talked to more people, and as I heard people out, and I started to read arguments, I went back the other way, and not just because I'm a season ticket member, but I thought, no, wait a sec, they have the right to do this, supply and demand, free market, all those things. And they have put in their time and, more importantly, their money and their energy in this team, and they have the right to do what they want, and I can't judge their motives. And that's the way, you know, I was thinking for then the next few days. And then I've kind of regressed back to the mean, to the median or whatever, back to the middle, where I realize that it's not my place to judge. And I realize every single person's going to have a different situation, financial, emotional, mental, whatever it is, whatever reason. And I cannot judge that. I can only judge my own intentions, and my own intentions are to go on both days and not to think about selling them. So long 11-minute rant on basically nothing. Oh, I shouldn't say that. Basically laying out both sides and really trying to relay that I understand both sides. I appreciate both sides. I've been on both sides, and I've been on both sides in the past week. But I've kind of settled down in the middle where really, A, it's none of my business what people do, and B, I'm really not judging, especially because every single person has a different situation and a different intention. All I know is I'm going to be there. I'm excited. I would love to meet a bunch of you either on the Friday night if you're lucky to go, or especially on the Saturday when it's slower, when I'm going to have to stay awake by walking around. Would love to meet a lot of you, and then we can sing happy birthday to myself all together. Oh, hey, Canucks fans, went for 11 minutes here, but I'd love your comments. I'm sure I'm going to get a lot of different feedback down below, but quite simply, do you think... I don't think the question is, do the season ticket members have a right to resell the tickets? Is, does it upset you that you're seeing such high prices from season ticket members, mostly on the secondary market for the day one of the NHL draft? Leave a comment below. I'd love to read and react and reply to what you think. I think this is a really interesting topic, and I'm looking forward to the diverse type of responses we're going to get. So please leave a comment below. I'd love to read, react, and reply. Subscribe if you'd like to. Like this video if you'd like to. Enjoy the day. Have a great day. God bless, and go Canucks go.